8-man elimination tag team action coming up here on the NAWA DFW second anniversary card. Rob Moore at ringside, and I do mean ringside, along with Johnny T. Now, I'll tell you one thing, Johnny, before we go any further with the business at hand. We're at PCW Arena in Arlington, Texas. PCW is Professional Championship Wrestling, an organization here. I work with them as an announcer, and I'm certainly glad to see NAWA here tonight. And I do want to thank the management at PCW for allowing NAWA to put on such a major card here tonight.
Well, it is great to see some, you know, area wrestling organizations working together, Rob.
Absolutely. These four men in the ring, they can hold their own with anybody, and we're about to see their opponents. And we're talking about an all-star team of sorts here in the NAWA DFW.
So is this elimination, or is it the first pin takes it?
It's my understanding that it's an elimination match. Now, I'm sure I'll be corrected if need be. But indeed, it is my understanding this is an eight-man elimination. A man gets pinned, he leaves. That's my understanding.
So we should see 7 pinfalls in this match before
That's
it's all
right.
over.
Pinfall slash submission slash
Although,
count out, DQs, what have you.
I guess it could just see 4, right? Because as soon as the 4 guys from one
That's
side are
true.
Pinned, it's all over.
That's very true. And here comes the other team. And what a colorful lot they are. Cliche goes Teddy, bar the door. This is going to be a wild one here. And clearly the fan favorites here, you've got Melvin in that. Now I know, Johnny T, about Melvin's split personality, if you will. Sometimes he's Melvin, and sometimes he's the more serious, more of a killer instinct, Marvin. But it appears he's going to wrestle this match here as Melvin. So I guess he's fairly normal, if you could say that.
If he becomes Marvin during the middle of the match, does he get paid double?
Gosh, I don't know. That's a good question. I think we'd have to ask the promotion about that.
I don't know if that's in our budget. Oh.
Max Muscles is coming to our table here.
You know me.
Oh, Rob.
Yes, I do know who he is.
You said you know him.
Not is that? But I know who he is.
Is that
Max
anything
Muscle.
To do with the Bible, biblical sense?
No.
No. Okay.
Nothing to do with knowing anybody in the biblical sense.
Oh, okay,
no.
Okay. Just checking
Nothing
on that.
Nothing to do with that. Listen to the fans here at the arena. You talk about 4 charismatic individuals here. You got Max Muscles. You've got Melvin. You've got Chris Richter, and you've got G Slice. All of them in the ring. Once and they're in 8-man tag team action here.
We got extra ringside with us. Mike Page is sitting here. And Mike, Lenny Lane has to face 2 men tonight. How do you feel about that?
No. It's not like that. John Allen's going to be facing Seth Shai. And then Lenny Lane's just going to sit back and take on whoever else he wants to face, whoever might sneak through that. Lenny Lane's leaving here as the champion. Don't worry about it.
Mike Page assuring that Lenny Lane will leave the champ, Rob. We'll see later on.
Yes, indeed. It all comes down to match time, and people can say anything they want, but nothing happens until it happens. So we shall see what happens here, especially in this 8-man tag match. And the man I do not envy at all, Terry the Book Stevens, officiating this contest.
Terry the Book Stevens. Actually, I got to check with him. I need to lay some action down in the Super Bowl.
Not that kind of book.
Different
kind of book. And Texas Red here at ringside shaking hands with Mike Page. And Melvin looks like he's sulking, and Max Muscle's going over to console him. I think they're all tending to the emotional well-being of Melvin. And they've dragged him over to what appears to be their corner in this contest. I don't know what Melvin could be pouting about right now, but I guess he's pouting because he's not the official man to start off the contest. And Max Muscles is in there, and I think he wants Terry Stevens to frisk him for foreign objects, and I know Max Muscles enjoys that. And Terry Stevens, he's...
Second generation right
here. Well, all right, 5-10. Oh, look at that. Well, we know where Terry is ticklish. Max Muscles, he's in there doing his thing. He He likes to have fun, but make no mistake about it, he's a tough customer inside that ring.
Hey, did you get a chance before the match to ask Terry the Book Stevens, our ref, how many points he's laying on the Mavericks for Tuesday? I'm thinking, if it's more than seven, I'm putting a couple dimes down on that.
Well, no, I didn't, and once again, different kind of book. But these fans are getting behind Max Muscles as he is set to lock up with Andrew Dalton. Now, Andrew Dalton, he's a second-generation wrestler as he goes behind with the waist lock. Wrong thing to do, though, on Max Muscles because Max knows how to get out of that waist lock. But Andrew Dalton is the son of Frank Dalton, and in case the name Frank Dalton is unfamiliar to some of our viewers, perhaps you know the name of Friday. We're talking about the handler of Kamala the Ugandan Giant. So it is. Texas Red wants me to do something about it. There's not a thing I can do. It's up to you guys. I'm just here to talk, for crying out loud. And I've already lost my train of thought. It's already been derailed several times, and that could derail anything. Max Muscles showing off that physique of his.
Man, I think Mike Page is over here pitching a tent.
Well, maybe Max Muscles can take him down a few pegs. I don't know.
Mike, don't stand up there.
Now, lock up, and Max Muscles with a go behind, and Andrew Dalton's getting felt up. And he's out of that ring quicker than you can say, well, never mind. Calling for a timeout, but that's not going to happen. Max Muscles doing some push-ups in the ring. I'm sure he'd like to be doing some push-ups a little closer to Andrew, but...
I think there's a lot of things Max Muscle would like to be doing.
Brian Lewis is screaming at me, and for the love of God, I don't know why.
Well, I know this. Max Muscle sure has the other team in disarray. Off their game plan.
Well, I'll tell you what, Max, he is unorthodox as they come, and I've seen plenty of unorthodox wrestlers in this building and elsewhere, but now it's Andrew Dalton with a side headlock on Max. Cinching down, and Max backing him up into the ropes, sending him across the ring and out. Max is down on his back, and Andrew...
Oh!
The old Greco-Roman lip lock right there. And a backdrop. And Andrew Dalton is in some serious trouble here. Max Muscles dragging him over to the corner, and now he tags in G-Slice.
They're like kissing cousins there for a moment.
G-Slice, the man from New
Orleans.
Splitting firewood there.
I guess we can forget about the third generation of Daltons.
Yeah, I think the Dalton family has had it now.
Yeah.
Especially with that stomp from G-Slice, who knows as many dirty tricks as anybody in the business.
It stops at the second generation.
Snapmare and a kick to the back. And now G-Slice on top. One, two, and only a two count. Very close to a three. And G-Slice certainly nowhere near as flamboyant as Max Muscles, but he gets the job done. On top with a cover. One, two, and once again, only a two count. Dalton kicks out. And here comes Melvin.
Is it Melvin or Marvin?
Well, it certainly looks like Melvin to me. He's got the familiar headgear on, and he's got the familiar contest. Now look at this. He wants a collar and elbow lockup.
I'm going to ask Mike Page, hey, if Melvin and Marvin both wrestle, do we have to pay them both? Do we have that in the budget?
I'm not really sure. As long as I get paid, I don't care who gets paid.
Between you and Rob Moore, we don't have any money left in the budget.
Well, I like Rob Moore, and if all else fails, somebody's got to go, you know.
Wait a minute. That would be... Wait a minute.
No, not you. I like you, too.
I work cheap.
Oh, look at this. That's a Gary from Melvin. He got Dalton dizzy and a flip plancha onto him. One, two, and look at this. Logan pulling him off.
Well, the M&M connection, Melvin Marvin, is going to town.
Oh, and here comes Chris Richter, and this man can do damage in any number of ways. He's been hardcore. He's been strictly technical. He's probably the most all-around wrestler in this organization as he takes Dalton down the clothesline on top with a cover, too. Only a two count. Interference there from Brian Lewis breaking it up, and now Dalton going to the eyes. And Dalton now coming off the ropes, and good Lord, look at that power hip toss, and now... Richter tags in G-Slice. Lightning fast moves here in this eight-man main event, or this eight-man match, pardon me. We've got the main event coming up later on, a three-way with Lenny Lane, as well as John Allen and Seth Shai for the NAWA DFW title. That's something to look forward to.
Well, and I think Mike Page, are you going to be at ringside for that big title match, Mike Page?
Oh, hell yeah, I will be. Oh, Dalton.